last time we did was in October of 2013. It's called Back There and Over Yonder. And this is sort of like a grandson of when electricity came to Arkansas. It's called Plugged In and Wired. And that's what we need to be right now. I'm feeling good tonight. I'm feeling real good. Yeah, I'm feeling better now. Huh? Drumsticks are in the bag in the truck. Drumsticks in the bag in the truck.
I just got the whole band.
Yeah, we got a new, since Ruby, we got a new girl now. Finally, after all this time, Ruby would love to do. But you know, Ruby passed away over 20 years ago, and I still miss her today. But we got another little Sammy B. Sammy B. so fine. She's going to do some stuff with us too, and we're going to do some dandy to the rescue and all that. But hell, you know, they say I still have too much fun. I say compared to what? I mean, I don't think we ain't had enough fun yet. We're going to have some more right now. If somebody tells you you got too much, say compared to what, man? We ain't even got started. We ain't even got started. But Johnny left his drumsticks in the bag where actually Jim Dandy did. I'm always to blame. You know why they got so many Joneses in the phone book? You're gonna hate this, because they got phones. Rescue me, baby, I'll tell you what. Yeah, y'all all right. Y'all the real ones right there. That's a wild bunch over there. That's a real wild bunch. Y'all, I ain't hold a candle to none of y'all, man. But I'll tell you what. Y'all can get lessons on being cool. Yes, I like watching her walk. She got your stick back though, Johnny. That is above and beyond the Call of Duty, baby. You are the one. Shoot. I can stand it, but I can't hardly. But you know, they say I'm having too much fun. Well, maybe. Nah. Thank you, sweetheart. Sammy B. Sobine, right here. My oldest and dearest friend in life, Mr. McGinley Ricochet Reynolds over here. And we've been together since the ninth grade. Too long. Know too much about each other. Over here, Mr. Brian Costner on the bass guitar. Mr. Arthur Pearson, Mighty Bo on the lead guitar. Russellville, Arkansas. And Mr. Johnny Bowling back here in the drums, brother Mr. Tommy Bowling, the timeless legend. He's the one. But here, plugged in and wired, that's what we did when we got electricity in Arkansas. We put pickups in the guitars, put guitars in the amplifiers in the wall, and we are plugged in and wired for sound profound, and that's what we're going to do right now. Come on. show. But now it's got a show. But now you gotta know I never felt better. Outside and inside, streetwise and socialized. Superficially similar, but slightly downsized. High, wider, more style. What came downtown? Your album right here is live album we go called Raunch and Roll. You're gonna look them right square in the eyes and say, Mama, because of you, I've got a hot, hot ride. There's a Balls of Fire album, but I remember a long time ago when Bob Seger was only about 17, 18 years old, he put out a song, it was called the Bob Seger System, it's called Ramblin' Gambler Man. We did a cover on that on Balls of Fire, and I just feel like playing it right now, because this is a real rock and roll. We got a few Ramblin' Gambler Men out there, I think we do tonight. money at the casino? You're talking about having it. Oh, shit. Pretty sure they got this loser. Lucky five. Lucky in college.
Thank you.
That must be, I'm playing my scribble records. It's always in tune. Where it be? Oh, y'all even took my board out of the case. I ain't seen it. That's the way it gets treated. They disrespect my board all the time. It's not good. Just because I don't have to tune it. Thank you, Jeff. This is a true story about a real person who lived to be the ripe old age of 105 years old. Now, he died at 105, but he still lives on in our hearts because he was one hell of a man, one of the original founding members of the Wild Bunch. But he never left the state of Arkansas. Didn't go across the river, didn't go across the state line. 105 years in Arkansas. I cannot comprehend that. I'm glad I saw Detroit even. But I love you, and I hear this is a story about old Uncle Elijah. And he was what I do. We'll be right back. Thank you very much. You know what we're doing right there? We are remembering our heroes is what we're doing. You know, it's a sin to forget the unforgettable, but we got to always remember our heroes. That was Uncle Isaac. He was one of our heroes. And also, this next song right here, it's about another hero. And she was a little lady sang with us with Jim Dandy to rescue many more. She passed away a little over 20 years ago of an inoperable brain tumor. And I still miss her every second of every minute of every day of her life goes by. She was a spitfire, she was, a lot like Sammy. Another one of a kind. And I'll tell you this. Finally, we got some other lady to come out here with us. You can tolerate the swinging dicks out there, excuse me. Because that's the test right there. That's the test of all tests, yes. We got ways to do that right here. She's got five big brothers up here watching out for her. She may be short, but she's about to pick five too, just like Ruby. This right here is a song out to Miss Ruby Starr. Sing her now. We live forever. We will never forget her. It's a sin to forget the unforgettable. You gotta remember your heroes, ain't that right? Oh, Helena Renown. One more time. Did you feel it? I can feel it. I can feel your heart. You got a lot of heart out there. Oh, hell. Another guy. You do one right here for another hero. He was my friend. He was a timeless legend. He was also the brother of my drummer, who's been with me for 28 years. This man, well, he passed away, but he's still alive with us. Because as long as you are remembered, you are alive. Hereafter and evermore. This is not Mr. Tommy Bowen. This song is Hero, called Post Toasty. This is mid-70s rock and roll. This right here, I'm telling you.
You can't cover it bad, or maybe it's rock and roll. That's what you're referring to. Yes.
No, we weren't playing. We weren't playing. We're serious about this shit. Rock was rock. Hey! We'll be right back. Cities, the Big Apple. A little bit intimidated, I might say, coming from Arkansas. Going to New York City. But we met this girl. Oh, she was beautiful. And I gotta tell you the truth was she was more than $50. I wanted her to seem affordable, you know what I mean? But she did, and this is the truth, she did love her work. She may have been a lady of the evening, but she was a queen about it. She loved it, and I loved it. We all loved it. And all I got to tell you is this song is called Happy Hooker. This boy child was standing on the corner. I bought this woman who looked good on the way. I had all nice and Dutch. I wanted only suit. The Sparks picked me out and told me it was cute. I said, you're cute too, without further ado. She said,
oh, $50, I'll make love to you.
The way she was looking, money just could not ever stand in the way. We went to her place, that's right, because we saw it first. There was no amount of money that could measure what she was worth. She was a real fine looker. We'll be right back. Tell you, I love the way Alton plays that slide guitar. Do you like slide guitar? I do too, and he says you. Now, the truth is, the best way I know for this story of it is for me to recommend my daughter, my friend. She was a real fine good girl. If you follow her, you know something? I got something I want to talk to you about at this particular moment. And that's about the one thing we won't be able to do together. Unless we could all become as one, which ain't too likely. But if we could all become as one, well then, hell, we might be able to walk through it together. Now, I ain't walked through it all the way yet. But there was a time I walked into it, and I had to go into it alone. That's this place called the Halls of Karma. And when you go into the Halls of Karma the way I did, I don't know. It might have been a hallucination. But I think it was real. I felt the presence of the two energies. The positive and the negative. Or God and the devil, however you want it. And they were pulling. And the sun wondered what to do with my miserable soul. Well, I couldn't have this at that moment, so I began bargaining for my soul real fucking fast. And out of this bargain, I gave the devil my body for the good and his needs while he's here on earth. And the Lord, well, hell, the Lord, he got my mind like he eventually gets all of our minds in one way or another, no matter what we do. And they both got me in between because they both got my soul. So the next time I come up, I want the Lord to please have mercy on my soul. On all of our souls. Mercy! Mercy!
Reflected in the sympathy of God.
I'm just trying to get real with them. I'm going to work up a sweat. Work up a sweat where we feel like we're raining on one another. It's a sex song with a sense of humor. Sort of like Titties and Beer was for Frank Zappa, another one of my heroes. This one right here is called Hot and Nasty. I love it. I love it. I'll never, ever be enough of it. Could I?
Call me, what the gun? I'm nasty.
my favorite part of the show, and I'll tell you why. You want to know? Because this is where I get to let my Johnny go. Ladies and gentlemen, another rock and rolling and bowling. This man right here, a legend in all strip bars, known a man, the brother Mr. Tommy Bowling. And the best drummer in the whole fucking world. Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Bowling on the drive!
We'll be right back. Yeah.
I will always love you. You are the real deal. You are the real people. You are the real Americans. You are the real people. Good night.
You are the best I know.
You are the best I know.
So come over here and hang out with them. If you guys will hang tight for just a second, we're about to